whizzing, coughing, choked. The cost of fossil fuels haunts us, and the reality is clear. The damage they cause is irreparable. The response has been to search for alternatives. Desperate efforts to harness energy from the wind, the sun, and Russian waters. Yet all this still come up short on efficiency, or risk destroying natural habitats. However, an alternative to alternative energy is on the horizon. But how to capture those sporadic energies has been a headache until scientists realized the source that's right in front of our eyes. Tribal electricity. When two objects made of certain materials rub up against each other, the balance between positive and negative charges on their surface will be broken. One object gains the other object's negative charge, that's when tribal electricity happens, and what scientists call the tribal electric effect. In 2012, Chinese-American scientist Zhongli Wan proposed an idea to harness this power by installing electrodes onto two surfaces that can be rubbed together and connecting wires between them. Electrons are able to freely along the circuit, and when those tiny little things move, they can generate electricity. Theoretically, friction between any two surfaces can produce tribal electricity, but using newly developed nanomaterials can multiply the number of contact points many thousands of times, greatly increasing the tribal electric effect.
有了这种纳米结构的话，是可以增加它的表面的接触的这个有效面积，增加它的表面的粗糙度，使得它更容易带电，能够具有更多的电荷来去实现机械能向电能的转换。The
researchers would use this machine to process the surface of ordinary polymer film, which will be bombarded by high-speed particles, making its surface rough. The backside of the sheet will be coated with thin layer of metal for its electrode. A processed film like that will be used to make a tribal electric nano generator, or TONE.
过去几年，我们将摩擦纳米发电机做成了不同的这种结构形式，来去收集环境中间不同的机械能，甚至是海水的波浪能。It's
hard to believe this ball can harvest the power of a wave. The polymer film with the outer electrode is formed into a plastic ball. Then another ball is put inside to rub up against the outer one. The design helps maximize the contact of two surfaces, no matter how it moves, so more electricity is generated. The electricity meter proved it can work. But to best demonstrate how motion can be captured and turned into energy, a wave pool will be used.
我们可以做成一个网络状的结构，这样在海平面中央，我们就可以实现波浪能收集。
Water is then added, and the waves begin. The net is hooked up to an LED light to measure its output, and the light turns on. When more generators are connected, the electrical output cranks up. Theoretically, a multi-layer floating net as large as China's Shandong province could provide electricity to the entire world, but in practice, there is still a lot of work to do.
摩擦纳米发电机的它的特性是一种高阻抗性的这样的一个发电器件，它输出的电压非常的高，输出的电流非常的低。我们今年新发表了一个工作，就是做了一个浮标系统，可以在能量管理、电源稳压的这样的一个调理之下，可以输出一个3.3伏的平稳的电压。那么这样的一个电压呢，后面我们可以去带一个单片机的系统。Scientists
hope the technology could be used in a smart factory, where vibration from heavy machinery can be captured and used to power sensors that monitor the machines themselves.
我们可以让这个智能制造变得非常的智能化，让我们实时的去获取在工业生产中间设备的很多的一些信息，来进行非常便捷的进行安全监测，形成这种自驱动的工业互联网。
Researchers see a future where we live in a completely wireless world, where everything can be self-powered, harnessing the power of motion.
智能化的重要支撑就是有传感器，传感器的重要支撑就是非能源。